Hello everyone, and English here. Yeah. Okay, I named the lecture Authentic Motivation because I'm not a motivational speaker. I'm just doing the stuff that makes me happy. And I will just talk about my experience and what helped me to reach the top. And I was enough lucky to reach the top, literally reach the top. So I'm supposed to point there. So as I said one more time, authentic motivation, not motivational speech, not the stuff that I was reading and then passing that to you. It's my life. I'm not saying everything is right, but that's me. Okay, before I start, I'm supposed to introduce myself. I graduated with a master's degree from the Faculty of Kinesiology in Sarajevo. I'm very passionate about the sport. Despite the fact I'm the playing already the second half of my life, I'm still passionate about it. I'm the first person from Bosnia who completed all six major marathons, which includes Berlin, Tokyo, Chicago, Boston, New York. Thank you. Besides that, I started that, I started that bug called the triathlon in Bosnia and Herzegovina. Now, Ironman is actually just the name, franchise. It's a long distance triathlon. You're supposed to swim 3.8 kilometers. After that, immediately ride the bike 180 kilometers and then run a marathon. 17 hours deadline, so kind of, that's it. Besides that, I was the first from former country, for former Yugoslavian republics, to be competitor at the Norseman. Norseman is the most extreme triathlon in the world. I was enough lucky to get the slot, but actually the point is to be sincere with you. You're applying for a slot and hoping you won't get it, but at least you can brag that you applied for a slot. Unfortunately, I got a slot, so it is what it is. Besides that, I'm very passionate about climbing, mountaineering, and I was in expeditions in Himalayas, Russia, United States, Argentina, France, Austria, Italy. I'm currently the president of the supervisory board of the Olympic Committee of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Not yet. Okay, I climbed my Mount Everest, yeah, that's it. So, after I established my credibility to say something in front of you, because you have to be someone to say something in front of you and you are future, for you, this is the, what's the name of this? This is future leaders. I'm leader of yesterday, so forget about it. So you are our future leaders. This is going just on its own. Hold on. I want to go back. Okay. One of my challenges, several years ago, I was called by the national team of Bosnia and Herzegovina to talk to players before the important game for the European Qualifier Championship. And they were playing versus Finland. With due respect to Finland, it's not Italy or Germany. So, but there is a player in a Finnish team called Puki. And Puki was creating the all problems for our team at the first game in Helsinki in Finland. So they needed assistance and motivation. So what I'm gonna say to the guys who play in Germany, Italy, England, their contracts are $10, $15, $20 million. What to tell them? What's the motivation? The only motivation you can communicate with those fantastic young people, they are just rich and there is nothing wrong about it. The only thing that I can communicate with them is love. Yeah, you hear me, love. So you have to have a passion. Money will come as a consequence of the doing the right things. But if the money is your goal in life, you're on the wrong path. you're doing something wrong. So do the right things in the right way. Money will come as a result of doing it. But don't be chasing, I apologize. Don't be all the time in chase for the money, because it's like chasing your tail. It's a never-ending game. So I explained them what the Sparta is. I explained them that Grandpa in Bosnia and Herzegovina would spend half of his retirement, monthly retirement, to buy the jersey with the name of Pjanic on the back. And they were looking at me, and then I realized how happy we are, because when we have friends, we know they are our friends. When they have friends, they don't know if their friends are with them because of the money or they like them. Tough life. Regardless, after I talked to them that night, they say it was the best game ever. As a clicker. So we won 4-0, 4-1. Actually, it was supposed to be 4-0. What I'm trying to say, motivation is like taking a shower. You need it every day and last for a short time. It has to be replenished all the time. So I'm talking about authentic motivation. So let's start first. What are the signs that things are going well for us? Okay. Do you have any idea what's the percentage of the world population with the roof over their heads? What's the percentage? We ate today, we are in good health, hopefully. Clean clothes, drinking, we have drinking water. We wash our cars in Bosnia with the drinking water. So, you know what is percentage of the people on the planet who have all of this? 7%, even less. If we add additional stuff to this list, we are getting into the 2-3%. And we still complain all the time. Complaining is like a sport. I ask you to remember number 8. I'll explain later. We can cry. We all cry. We all cry. We guys are shy, so we hide when we cry. There's a difference, but we all cry. So we can cry. That's very important. We'll get back to that. So, what is this? We will all face the same thing soon or later. Anyone disagree? I found a good price. Yeah, pointed shovel with handle. 32.5 convertible marks. That's where we go. That's the thing that will end our journey, regardless of the religion. Well, not 100%. So what I want to say that I was thinking about important elements that helped me to reach the top. To understand, first is fear. West Ridge of Everest.
Mi ne idemo nikud I ne radimo ništa. Mi smo jedna velika hipnotizana gomila.
Are they crazy? No, they're just chasing their dreams. They live a life. Life is a journey, point A, point B. You just go and travel. The game is funny because you don't know when it's gonna end. Can anyone tell me in this room that with 100% accuracy that you will wake up tomorrow morning No, ain't happen. No guarantees. Your life will end. I apologize for being pessimistic. This is a fact. I don't want to be pessimistic. But if you realize that you're on a journey, you'll be able to fill that journey with good stuff. Don't fill that journey with money and not spend it. Spend the money. So, if you're talking about that irrational fear that blocks us all the time, that we cannot move forward, let's define it. So, if we define that irrational fear that is believed that something bad will happen, we in Bosnia, we are taught from childhood not to laugh because we might be crying after, of course. That's very natural. But those, you know, the Bosnian proverbs are unbelievable. It's not even translatable into the English. Za one koji govore naš jezik, nemoj se smijat, oplakat ćeš. Just for my local friends. So, can we believe that something good will happen? Yes, we can. But we are afraid all the time, what's going to happen? And we live that fear. And when you realize that you should believe that something good will happen, you'll find yourself old. The guy on the left side, his name is Luis Enrique. ¿Qué tal? He's Catalonian here. So he was a coach in Barcelona 5 years ago. They played a match in the Champions League versus Paris Saint-Germain. And they lost in France 4-0. So, Luis Enrique, who is a marathoner and who is a triathlete, it didn't go everything well in his life. He lost his daughter when she was 9. She got a cancer and she died. But he's the guy who believed that something good will happen. So they lost 4-0 in Paris. They play in Barcelona. Next game, they are supposed to win the 5-0, which is impossible because the Paris, the team owned by the rich Middle East businessmen and oil tycoons, they never lost internationally 5-0. But Luis Enrique, he believed that something good could happen.
Neymar.
So, we have a right to believe that something good will happen. If we believe, if we go from our heart, we can do unbelievable things. I will show you. I know. The rope, he's with his partners taking a video. So how we can find out what is he thinking about where he is, why? There is only one way. Let's first locate him. Toblerone, between the Switzerland and Italy. altitude, it's okay, below 4,500. Not a big deal. But on the ridge at the top, it's really narrow and intimidating on the both sides, 2 kilometers on the both sides. So don't look down. If you go up, don't look down. Just, you will look down either way going back. So how to find out what is he thinking about? Is he better than we are? No, he's not. He's just chasing his dreams. There is only one way to find out. The only one way to find out is to go there. So I went over there because I was watching this video many times and I said, I'm gonna do it. Yeah, but I didn't go there by myself. I went there in a team, and in the team there is one woman. She's the first woman from Bosnia and Herzegovina who climbed Matterhorn. She's so brave and she's so powerful. In our days, it is very important to send a message. So some things are done from the heart. You cannot do everything with the muscles, as many men believe. You have to have a heart for those things. So I didn't stop over there. This is my favorite photo in a cell phone. When I ask my friends to do something, they say, well, I can't do that. Really? 12 years old boy who climbed Mont Blanc. Friend of mine asked me, do you think that my son can climb it? I just wanted to beat Slovenians. So I said, yes, we'll do it. We'll be before them because they are better in the region. They are the best. So we climbed together Mont Blanc. Little boy, 12 years old. So don't tell me that you can't do something because I'm going to pull out my cell phone and show you the photo. So, of course, we are coming to the first thing to remember. It's not coming from some smart guy from the ancient Greece. It's coming from the guy who invented the car production, Henry Ford. And this is very true, whether you think you can or you think you can't. You're right. What you're gonna think, that's your choice. This is how I see every team, every community, every group. If you take care of each other, if we hand over food, water, rope, we can go to the top. If you do it on our own, pushing others around us, ain't work well. So we are coming to the next. I want to go back. We are concerned. We live concerned life. We worry all the time about everything, even about the things that we cannot affect. I asked a friend of mine, she's a psychologist. I asked, can you explain me why we worry about everything? She said, that's very easy. And this is not easy. Yes, it is. So we have to ask ourselves, why do we worry? Very simple question. After that, ask yourself, can we influence, can we affect it while we worry? So, if the asteroid is going to hit the planet, what are you gonna do? I have an idea. Let Bruce Willis take care of it. Now, not anymore. But just make a party. Call friends and wait for the last day because you cannot fix it. But don't be worried about it. We worry all the time about the stuff that is not pertinent to us, and after 24 hours, it will really look ridiculous. So think about it. Don't waste your energy to worry. Make a plan. Can you only figure out if you can affect it? If not, change your focus. Get out, have a coffee, read something, meet someone. Do something different. But don't be worried, please. That's very important. Don't worry, be happy. 98% of the people on the planet, based on the research, are like this guy, like everyone else, uncertain, just survival to pay the bills. Play it safe, please. Don't risk, play it safe. Have a boring life. To pity oneself, of course, average ambition. Do you want to be average? If you want to be average, you won't be today here. So you're not average. Good news for you. Sometimes I have a good news as well. And the ever-present fear, we're all the time about fear. So, you like it. It's not easy to say how to be motivated, but let's say how to be unmotivated. Ignore your passions, please. Ignore your passions. Don't be passionate about anything. Stop trying to learn something new. Can you imagine in the world of the technology you stop to learning? You're out. In 30 days, you're out. You're outdated. Cease trying to be who you are, be someone else, or copy someone else. And of course, believe that your ideas are doomed to fail. Whatever you think when you hear, you know, someone by the side, it's impossible, you have to listen to them. Surround yourself with people who couldn't care less about you. That's my favorite. Think about people who you are with. Think about your time. That's very important. Don't find yourself in the company of positive people. It's contagious. Don't do that. So, we learn how to be unmotivated. I like this one. You like it, huh? Do we have an answer? Not my job. They're selling, you can buy the toys, you know, not my job. So this is very true in my society in Bosnia and Herzegovina. Not my job. The guy is doing a line, he's not moving the tree. So don't be like that in a life. If you can help someone, if you can do something extra, do it. But don't be like that. It's too boring. So we are coming to 2%. 2% people with the self-confidence, follow your dreams, explore the unknown, choose happiness. Happiness is something that you choose. It's not lottery, it's not a bingo. Pick up the small good things. At the end of the day, you'll have the decent chunk of the good stuff with you. But happiness is a choice. It's not something that's happening accidentally. Satisfaction, that's also your choice. Love change, and don't set limits and barriers because you have no clue what your limit is. We're all the time improving in a sport, in a science, in a culture, technology, not even to mention. What's your limit? You don't know until you try. There is a good Japanese proverb. If you think you can't do something, try to do it for 1 minute, 60 seconds, and you will have the better info. And take everything you can from life because you are mortal and you forget about it. Usually people, they stop and they don't know, they are uncertain. But if you go through, there is a blue sky, always, always, always. Life, rainy days, sunny days. I still haven't met anyone who spent only the sunny days. All of you experienced loss. All of you experienced sorrow in your life. Don't live the life and expect that every day is a sunny day. It's impossible. Be prepared. Because your action depends solely on you. What's gonna happen? You can affect it a little bit, or maybe not at all. But how you're gonna deal with it, that's your choice. Think about it. So, this is the graphical where the 98% of the people spend their life. It's crowded in a small circle. It's very crowded over there. But people, they like to be there. They brush the teeth, they go for work, go back home, pajamas, Netflix, brush the teeth, sleep. 50 years, 40 years. So, 168. I like the numbers. So, I was doing the math. I like math. 168 represents number of hours in 1 week. So I did some math. It's a beauty sleep, 9 hours every day. It's a Japanese work habits, 6 times 10 hours a week. Reading every day, 1 hour. Of course, personal hygiene, workout. I'm not fitness guru, but your body is the only place where you're gonna spend your entire life. You can treat yourself as a garbage container. That's perfectly fine. That's your choice. But that's where you're gonna stay until the end of your life. So make sure that you smoke too. Put that smoke into your body as soon as possible. So, this is total 160 hours. It's not even 168. So we have extras. You can play with the numbers. Do it by yourself, but play with the numbers and you will figure out what the time is. And now we are coming to time management. Time management is a very fancy term that everyone is talking about time. I don't think that we can manage time, but we can manage ourselves. There's a difference. How we manage ourselves. The guy who sold us everything. Correct? He sold us everything. He was genius. He was smart. He was on his own. He died fairly young. His words, not mine. The most precious resource we all have is time. Because it's limited. And the game called life is funny because we don't know how much we have. Use it wisely. So, based on this, a friend of mine is calling me. He said, hey, I'd like to work out with you tomorrow. I said, sure, see you 5 o'clock at the intersection over there for the short run. 5 a.m., of course. He said, you're crazy. I said, yeah, I know. He didn't show up. I'm sending him photos. There is even better one. Yep. And the next time he showed up, after that he completed the triathlons, he changed his life. It's up to you. Whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. 5 o'clock in the morning, fine. You can stay sleeping as well. That's also fine. You'll be just average. Very short section of my lecture is a change. Don't resist. It's natural to resist to any change. That's psychology. That's we humans. I like this one. You can Google it up. Kubler-Ross, change of curve. Forget about all those elements, the shock, denial, frustration, depression. Skip all the way there to a little bit experiment, making decision and integration. Because in nowadays, for the changes, resistance is futile. You cannot resist changes. You can just hop in. Or you can choose maybe the painful path to go all those elements that science proved. Not me. This is science. Kubler-Ross change curve. Hop there on the decision and integration. 55 seconds, excellent. Gratitude, that's the point. That's the point. This is me on the left and me on the right. 8,000 meters, 26 hours in the tent, South Cole, uncertain, am I gonna be alive? Tent for two, five of us. One Sherpa doesn't have even a mask. He's trying just to stay calm. We ended up in really bad weather. The question is always, why do we need this? What's the point? I drive car, I sleep in a bed, I have a heating, I have a food in the fridge, drinking water, you know, from tap. Why am I doing this? I'm doing this just to be grateful. Because in Sarajevo, I can go out and have a coffee for two convertible marks, €1. Up there on 8,000, I need to spend 1 hour melting ice, going out, risking frostbites. And I'm a very happy person. In the morning, shower. I didn't take shower for 46 days. It wasn't that bad, come on. But it is what it is. So can you imagine me when I have opportunity to have shower every morning? I'm very happy, I'm singing. So that's why I'm doing that. You don't have to climb Everest. You don't have to torture yourself to be a grateful person. But you can become a grateful person because of the everything you have. You know, those signs were that we are doing well. Remember of it, that small percentage. So we have father and son, Sports Illustrated, the photo of the year, 15 years ago. I keep this in my office. If I'm lazy to do something or to do my workout. This kid, he wasn't lucky as you are. He got the bone cancer. He lost his leg, but he didn't stop. And even they are competing, you see the start numbers, and you can see it's pouring rain. In Bosnia here, the people, when they wash their hair, kind of, they stay at home for 24 hours. Yeah, that's habits. You know, when I completed my first Ironman triathlon, it was kind of new stuff. So I wasn't asked, was it hard? How was the swim portion? So they asked me, okay, you swim. I said, sure, first we swim, then we ride the bike and we run. And they asked me, so after you swim is first portion and then you ride the bike? I said, yeah. And they say, wet hair? Yeah, wet hair. I jump on the bike and the wet hair. Can you imagine that disaster? Because the draft is the enemy of all people in this region. It kills. If you open the two windows at the same time, you're done. You're done. Forget about your career. So, guys, just a fact. Just a fact. Father and son, Spaniards. The kid wasn't kind of lucky as you are. He couldn't express himself in a way that we are supposed to express ourselves. But they were running marathons together, father and son. So be grateful every morning for everything. It's not in our culture, especially in Western culture. It's a profit. We are running for money. But we forgot about the stuff that we are given. And it's not for free. And meet my friend Mustafa. He's a blind person. He can't see. He was interviewed by the web portal, and he stated that he would like to be in a sport, but there is no one to coach him. 168. There is always time for someone else. First time when someone tells you, I have no time, they actually tell you, I have no time for you. And that's okay. You decide if you're gonna keep those people in your life. But it's not correct statement, I have no time. I have no time for you. And that's fair. Okay, I have no time for you. So Mustafa, he said there is no one who can kind of coach him. I called them, give me his phone number. I said, we'll work out 6 months, 3 times a week for 2 hours. We'll use the shoelace that I didn't even buy. I just pulled it out from my old sneakers. And we work out together for him to become the first blind person who will run the half marathon race in Sarajevo. 21.1 kilometers. running in the dark. So when you open eyes in the morning, just be happy and don't complain, please. I'm not asking you. Thank you. I'm not asking you to run half marathon, but just be happy. Because what's the point of life? To be happy. What's gonna bring that happiness? Your choice. Depends on your preferences. We became friends. I was about to teach him many stuff, but actually he was teaching me. Of course, the race day is always raining. That's life. People are happy around us, and we are coming to the finish line, and he's asking me how far we are from the finish line. I say, about 100 meters. And he told me, I would cry now if I can. But he can't. He can't produce tears. So going back to the science that we are doing well, number 8, we can cry. Even if you're crying, be grateful because you can express your emotions. He can't. In the meantime, of course, it's a happy end, Hollywood happy end. He graduated as the first the blind person in the Sarajevo University Law School. He got a job, he married, he lives in Sarajevo, and I'm supposed to take him out for lunch next week. So, it's a good life. He's not complaining. So no one has right to complain. He's not complaining. He just live a life. Live a life. I mean, it's okay, IT, dollars, contracts, everything. But life is only one, and it will go just like that. Trust me, I know that. What's your excuse? Do you have it? Please, no excuse. Don't say, I have no time. My treat from the top of the world and end of my lecture.
Zajedno smo rasli.
Thank you very much.
Grade ja i ti, isto plavo nebo poklonilo nam stil. Iz potrebe lića sanjali smo sne, ko će brže rasti, ko će ljepši biti. Ti si bio velik, a rodio se ja, sigma na uz osmije, slao si mi san. Dječak raste, zavolio teta, ostao je ovdje, vezan za svoj grad. Bilo gdje da krenem, o tebi sanjam, punili me svi tebi vole. Čekam s nekom čežnjom, na svjetla tvoja, Sarajevo.
And now, one hard question. There's only time for one question left. Who's gonna be the one?
Okay, the gentleman over there. Yes. Only one question, please. Yeah, we have no time. We're in a rush.
First of all, I'm so lucky to have this question. Second of all, I have to say thank you for everything that
you've
done. And also thank you for everything that you will do. I'm sure that you will do. But my question for you is, what's your next adventure?
My next adventure is that I became the member of the steering board of the association who is helping the parents of the kids with disabilities. So that's where I'm going to convince my friends who own the companies to pay money to that association. So that's my adventure. If there is something higher than Everest, let me know what to do.
You can visit the South Pole, just an idea.
Yeah, the South Pole is altitude like Mont Blanc. It's so expensive, so I have to convince, like I was convincing for the Everest, the companies and sponsors to support me, but never say never. But right now I'm very focused to use my position in the public to convince people to spend money for good. So that's it.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.